need to get home. I need to get home. How will I go?
Hey guys, my name is Darren, otherwise known as Sparky, and I like to run around and attempt to catch rain in my mouth, but as it isn't raining, I'm bringing you another Defending Tips video. I'm taking a slightly different approach to the series, meaning that the videos will be a bit shorter but more specific upon a subject and, fingers crossed, more frequent. Confidence as a defender, which said backwards is rednegdi, asa, ectidinoc. I'd love to say that's a Latin term for something mysterious and beautiful, but sadly, I'll only be bringing you disappointment and that means absolutely nothing. So anyway, let's go straight into this. So a lot of players I've noticed lack the confidence to speak up and be vocal whilst defending. This can come down to shyness, not wanting to mess up, and an age gap within the team. Every defence needs a leader, someone to lead the line and someone who is confident in their own ability to defend every situation. You need to understand your strengths and weaknesses, and most importantly, have the courage to speak up and organise the back line. With your own self-confidence, it will also rub off on others around you, a domino effect, so to speak. Anyone who has never made a mistake has never tried anything new. A quote from Mr. Albert Einstein himself: with confidence, you'll be challenging yourself to make slightly more daring tackles or make the call to aim for you at a corner. A good method on raising confidence is watching a defending video of a defender you look up to. I personally love watching the Maldini and Nesta videos. You then want to be like them, and again, you feel more fired up. Even a song that gets you pumped up, I'm not talking like Celine Dion sort of songs, but something a bit more fast paced. I like listening to something like 30 Seconds to Mars, and I just want to choke down my fridge because I'm so fired up and ready to fight for every ball in the game upcoming. I personally find that my competitiveness and determination to wanting to be the best pushes me. I'm not perfect, I make mistakes, but it's all about recovering and learning from it. My big problem is that I'm less vocal if we concede in the VFL game. I still have the willingness to win the game, but I feel like I could have done better within that situation, and it's trying not to be too hard on myself or someone else who made a mistake. I also know I'm not the best in the air. I won't be scoring 10 goals a season from corners, but that's something I've accepted, and I resort to proving myself by making sure that the team gets clean sheets. I've also been called shit, overrated, among many other beautiful words, but I've learned not to care and aim to prove them wrong. You need to be careful not to turn self-confidence into being selfish or egotistical, if that's the right word to use. As I learned as a kid, there is no I in team, although there is five I's of individual brilliance, but we'll keep that one quiet. So without turning this into an emotional, motivational video, I'll summarise this up. Don't be afraid to be the leader within a defence. If you make a mistake, learn from it and aim to be better than you already are. Most importantly, just believe in yourself. And that's that. I hope I've helped a few of you out. If you have anything you want me to cover in the future episodes, let me know in the comments. And as always, take care, farewell, I'll be just saying goodbye. I don't fucking care. Yeah.